amazing.
Hello, my name is Rio Yanez, and welcome to Day of the Dead in the Time of Change, our Dia de los Muertos celebration 2008 here at SomArts. And it's an exciting year to have a Day of the Dead exhibit. It's an exciting year to talk about change. And this exhibit is artists from all over the world interpreting their ideas of celebrating life and celebrating death and doing it in the context of change. We have an amazing, amazing setup this year. Our architect, Nick Gomez, has designed this space using pallets. And if you look around, everywhere you look, there's lots of pallets, lots of different wooden structures. And some of them you can see through, others the light is coming through them. It's very, very kind of organic look. You know, a lot of the wood is still very rough and raw, so there's just this kind of organic feeling to it. And instead of a series of rooms, which has been a lot of what the exhibit has been in the last few years, it's actually more of a city this year. And the way artists have used the pallets and used the wood to create their spaces has been really, really amazing and really inspirational. You know, there's a lot about how different cultures around the world celebrate life and mourn death. And to do it in the context of the city that we've created, of the wooden pallets, I think is very interesting. And I think it's a new challenge. It's a new challenge for us as curators, but it's also a new challenge for the viewer to come in and to take in this exhibit in a very non-traditional way. You don't see art like this very often. So it's an exciting experiment, and I'm very, very happy with the results.
Poem thing that we learned in second grade that we heard a CD of Colombian kids singing, and we made up a dance to go with it, and we performed it, but we also had little shoebox altars that we put around our little Garfield Park that we made. It's like we tried to recreate the procession that goes around 24th Street on Day of the Dead. And we had some buildings from 24th Street, like the Brava Theater and Casa Lucas and something like that. Stuff like that. We did a whole bunch of shoebox altars honoring a person that we did, and then we made little flip books for the person. And
did you learn a lot about what Day of the Dead means?
Yeah. Because, like, it's not, like, actually a scary thing, but it's, like, a celebration of the dead.
Okay,
stop
knocking. This is more like a feather.
Hello, my name is Sean Griggs, and this is my work that I've contributed to the SomArts Cultural Center's celebration for Day of the Dead. And it's called Esperanza, which is hope. And it's my depiction of the current state of the world right now, and what we got going on in the United States. I've represented the United States right now as a kind of a rundown house and in need of some help. And with this as being the old regime leaving, and a tree that's been neglected, that's sprouting new leaves for a new beginning. And if you look over to the left, coming in from the left is a much more powerful, energetic group of people, including the wagon carrying all the necessary items to help the building get spruced up again. You can see the paint cans and the the green light, the lights, the compact fluorescent light bulbs, and the corn oil and the ethanol instead of regular oil, and the birds of peace, the doves, and that's kind of where I came with it. I feel in this time, day and age, we need to be much more optimistic about what's going on, and this is just a painting that depicts my optimism. And I'd just like to, again, extend my thanks to SomArts for inviting me to this. It's been a real big pleasure to be here, and it's an incredible show, and I think it's a great way to let people know a little bit more about Day of the Dead.
I'm Decoy99. That's my artist name. My name is Lynn Celeste Connor, but I go by Decoy99. Look for me on YouTube. I'm Chiricahua Inda, which is the correct name for Chiricahua Apache. I'm a direct descendant of Cochise. Our last tribal chief, Geronimo, was a member of our group. We were decimated from several thousand to 300. At present, we are 500. This piece is to honor the people who suffered that unacknowledged Holocaust and who still suffer today. My grandmother was a beater and painter, and she had me beating, painting, and writing by the time I was 5. I really love history, the history of beadwork. There are photographs of artifacts in the corner. The artifacts are generally found only in museums at this point. Our tribal historian, Michael Darrow, and I are working on rebuilding a collection of our own artifacts to take it out of the hands of people where we have no control of it, and to make it accessible to our tribe. The Nets, Chiricahua Inda people, were nomadic, and as they wandered, they incorporated things from everywhere they went. So these nets incorporate every kind of bead or beadwork style that you've ever seen, and they also, to me, represent nets represent living in the here and now, incorporating from moment to moment everything that comes to you in your environment. So it's inclusive. So the nets represent a renewal, being present, and living empowered. Let's see. Oh yeah, and speaking about empowerment, this SomArts show has totally made me feel strength, inspired, curious. And there's so much amazing work here. I'm flabbergasted. I love it. Thank you. Thank you, Rene.
My name is Saha Raj, and welcome to my piece. It's called Buried in Michigan, and I dedicated this piece to my grandfathers, who were both buried in Michigan, in a place that they weren't born and that they didn't feel was home. So this side of the piece represents their life in Palestine, where they're both from. And this is just some photos and imagery of the town that we're from. And then the other side of the piece represents Michigan, which is just kind of where they both landed for various reasons and where they spent a lot of their lives.
My name is Italiana Lopez. This installation is called The Virtual Afterlife. And this is an interactive map about the people and the shooting victims in Mission during the week of the last month. In three weeks, died seven people. And I did a map, interactive map of these people. And you can see in the map where these people died. And where these people died and when these people died. And you can realize that they died more or less in the same place and at the same time.
On election day, November 4th, we will be having our closing kind of closing ceremony, closing celebration. We're going to be observing the election, and it may be a night of celebration or a night of mourning. We don't know right now, but it'll be a very interesting night to be here amongst artists and amongst friends.